Well, that's going to be, and then I'll go ahead and start the hole for the mold blocks. But we've got the sprue plates just about done. All right, I've already ready. I've drilled the hole with a number 3 drill bit. I wasn't going to bother showing you how to drill and tap a hole, but you need to take some care when you're tapping a hole. Use cutting fluid on your tap. You don't want it to break off inside, otherwise it's an absolute nightmare to fix. But the quarter 28 hole to drill and tap, you drill the number 3 drill bit or a 7/32. You'll turn it a quarter of a turn, back it off, turn it some more, back it off, and you keep doing that until you reach the bottom of the hole for the length of bolt you've got. Or, I mean, if you're going to use a different size fastener, of course you use a different size drill bit and everything. But always remember to back it off. You go a little bit and back it off, and that'll keep you from snapping off your tap. Okay, I wanted to show you real quick where we're at with this. I went ahead and I drilled and tapped the hole for the mold blocks. I put the plate on. I marked the center line for the blocks because I want the hole, obviously, bored dead center. I drilled a hole in the sprue plate. Just started the hole about 1/8 inch deep in the top of the blocks. Now we're going to go ahead and take this off, put it in the vise on a milling machine, and get it centered perfectly. Drill about 3/4 of the way with a 3/8 drill bit. We'll go about 3/4 of the way the depth of the cutter I made. I'll show you that part. You will get to see that part. But that's where we're at so far. Alright, here we are in the mill. I've drilled the first pilot hole all the way center, almost the entire length of what the total length of the bullet is going to be. The 3/8 drill bit I have in here right now, I'm going to go down and it'll wind up going about 3/4 of the total length of the bullet. You don't want to take and go all the way, obviously, because the nose of the bullet, at least the nose of my bullet, is not going to be 3/8 inch in diameter. So I want that to be formed by the cutter for the bullet that I made. Go ahead and turn it on. Go down to 3/4 inch. Cutting fluid. That's good enough. That's deep enough right there. I'm going to change that bit out. I'm going to put a boring head in. Right now I have my milling machine, I've got the R8 collet drill bit, a drill head adapter. I'm going to go ahead and swap that out and put a boring head in, and then we'll start boring the hole. All right, we're ready to start cutting. I've got it, the mold block centered. I've got the our cutting tool starting in it, and I had to center it up. We have a visitor today. As I mentioned before, this mold is going to be for Iraq Veteran 8888, and this is actually, he's actually here visiting with us. He's going to observe as we cut.
In the flesh.
I'm going to turn the mill on and plunge it down. Now keep in mind that the cutter is about only 3/8 inch in diameter, or in total width right now. The hole is 3/8 inch in diameter, so I'm going to plunge it in. My total diameter that I'm going to finish with is going to be 468. That's why I can plunge it in, and then we'll adjust the boring head and work it out. As you can see, this is a milling machine boring head, which we have. I'll show you a better picture of it later as we adjust it out. Check my depth. I don't want to go too far. Oh, we have a good half inch to go. Put a little more cutting fluid on it. Wear your safety glasses. Eric and I are both wearing our safety glasses. About another 300 thousandths. Yeah, I know I keep stopping, but I'm very paranoid. I don't want to go too deep. If we do go too deep, if it's within reason, guess what? We can fix that. We can just mill the top of the mold block off later on. But we've got a little bit more to go. And now we begin the adjustment of our boring head out. Well, I guess you can see that on the video. Here's the adjustment for the boring head. I'm going to run the bit out about 10 or 15 thousandths at a time. I'll run the run it out, and you'll be able to see. This is a long, time-consuming process. I'm going to start and stop the video on and off as I check the diameter of the hole. It's going to probably take me an hour to do this carefully, so that is what you're going to see. I'm going to be running it out and checking the depth of the hole, or actually the diameter of it. I want to make sure we get the diameter right and don't go too big. But I'm going to pause the video right now, and then we'll pick up in a minute. I haven't made a lot of progress. It's going to be slow. But we're leaving the cutter in the hole and slowly adjusting the boring head out 20 thousandths or so at a time. It's got to cut the nose of the bullet before it can cut the base where the lube grooves are. So when you get to this part with your boring head, just take your time. It's going to be slow. I'm guessing it could be as long as 4 hours. I'll probably wind up quitting and going to eating dinner and coming back. Eric will be home. It won't be anytime soon. But when I'm done, we're going to have a nice 468 or 470 diameter Martini bullet mold. And you know, we didn't have to spend $119 from RCBS, even though they make an excellent mold if you've got the money. Let's go ahead and turn it on. Cutting, as you can see, there's a lot of black coming out, but it's slowly.